Hi guys, welcome back to another video. As I promised, I'm going to be making today's video about the difference between an owner-operator who is leased onto a carrier and an owner-operator running under his or her own numbers. Ready? Let's go! So to understand the differences, first let me talk about the similarities between the two. Both owner-operators have their own trucks and sometimes their own trailers, although this is not always the case with someone who leases onto a carrier. Both owner-operators are responsible for their own expenses. Both owner-operators have the freedom to make their own schedule. Now that we looked at the similarities, let's go ahead and look at the differences. Number one, authority, and this is probably the most obvious difference that everyone knows about. An owner-operator who leases onto a carrier does not have their own MC or DOT number. This also means they don't usually have their own apportioned license plates because those are related to the MC number, and they don't have an IFTA account either because that's also related to an MC number. So what does he do? He leases onto a carrier who has their own authority and provides him with his IRP plates and provides him with IFTA decal stickers. On one hand, there's the owner-operator who gets to actually run and make money, usually a percentage of the gross of each load. And on the other hand, there is the carrier who just gained a truck and a driver to add to their fleet and help them move some of their loads. So it's a win-win situation. Now, an owner-operator with his own authority, with his own MC number, with his own DOT number, does not rely on a carrier for his business. He's completely independent, he can book his own loads and dispatch himself and keep 100% of what he makes. Number two difference is responsibility. Both types of owner-operators have control over their business. They have income, they have expenses, they pay taxes, and they have freedom to choose. But the owner-operator who leases onto a carrier actually does not bear as much responsibility as the owner-operator operating under his own authority. To make this point as clear as possible, let's go to the board. Now, to make it clear, I am not talking about expenses here. We'll talk about those later in the video. What I'm talking about is actually the responsibility of running the company, making sure it's in compliance. So here are some things that a carrier or an owner-operator with their own authority has to think about on the daily. Number one is, of course, getting their authority, the MC and DOT number. Then there is the UCR, and you have to register and re-register every single year. BOC3, also annual update. And guess what? A lot of these things have either quarterly filings or annual filings. Some of them have monthly filings, like some state permits. But basically, for the most part, the only thing that a lease on operator has to worry about and is responsible for is the 2290, the heavy vehicle use tax. Everything else is the carrier's responsibility. Because when you lease onto the carrier, you're your own boss, you're your own company, you're just operating under the authority of the carrier. But operating under their authority, according to the FMCSA, means that you are part of this carrier's fleet. So it is this carrier's responsibility to make sure that you are in compliance. And if they don't make sure that you're in compliance and they don't file the IFTA on time, which goes under their MC and DOT number, or the IRP, the apportioned license plates, that also go under their MC and DOT number, even though they are for your truck and are going to be on your truck, or they don't file and pay state permits on time, or they forget to file their biennial update, which is the MCS 150, or they forget to give you stickers, they are risking their reputation. So this is the big one. Now, a lot of people wonder, hey, as a lease on operator, why do I have to give away 25 or 30% to the motor carrier to lease on to them? Because usually lease on operators get around 70 to 75% on average of the gross of the load. Well, it's because of this, because it's the carrier that has to make sure that everything is in compliance, and they have to make sure that all the safety audits are passing. They have to be sure that the record keeping is there on your truck as well. Now, the carrier is taking on some degree of risk when leasing you on. They do that with company drivers as well. Company drivers can affect the carrier CSA score by the way they drive the truck and by how compliant they are on the road. So if heaven forbid you get an out of service order or you're violating your logbook, it's the carrier CSA score that goes down. So that's just a little bit of insight for you. Now, an owner operator operating under their own authority is exactly the same as a carrier. They are responsible for all of these things, for all of these filings, and making sure that they're in compliance. And it's their CSA score that's affected when something happens on the road. Number three difference, getting paid. There is a significant difference in how you get paid when you're running under your own numbers versus when you're leased on to a carrier. Usually when you're leased on, what does a carrier do? Well, they pay you every week or sometimes twice a month. But have you ever wondered, when does the carrier actually get paid? Well, the reality is, after the load is delivered, it can take brokers 30, 60, sometimes 90 days to actually pay the carrier. So basically, the carrier is giving you money before they actually get paid. Now, as an owner-operator operating under your own numbers, you will be dealing with what carriers are dealing with, the payment dilemma. You deliver a load and then you're waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting.
Where is my money?
Yeah, as an owner operator running under your own authority, you have to wait those 30, 60, 90 days sometimes, unless you decide to factor your loads. When you factor your loads, you pay a small fee, usually a percentage of the load, to get your money in advance. Why would you want to get paid faster? Well, after all, the one thing that can kill a carrier pretty quickly is the lack of cash flow. No cash?
No fuel.
No fuel?
No running capability.
No running capability?
No money.
Number four, the difference in income. Okay, back to the board we go. And it's so colorful right now, I am so excited. Okay, it might be very colorful, but if you don't understand what's written here, it's pointless. So let me explain. These are our actual numbers from the month of September on one owner-operated truck. So this is the actual income with the dates and the amounts that each load paid, and these are the actual expenses, what it was and how much it cost. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to really look at what is the difference between being own authority owner operator or a lease on operator. So just to give you an idea, income, as you can see, the gross income for September was $39,700. The total expenses for the month of September were $13,204.98. So what were our expenses in the month of September? Well, number one, we had to pay our accountant for doing our taxes. Always awesome. Then we had the DAT load board, fuel expense for this truck, insurance costs for this truck, ELD, maintenance, permits, taxes. And these taxes, by the way, include also our LLC tax that we have to pay every year, and this will be important in just a minute. There were tools for the truck and truck washes. So if you're an owner operator with your own authority, you get to keep 100% of your income, but you also have to take care of 100% of the expenses. So using these numbers, if you were an owner operator with your own authority, you would make $39,700 gross minus $13,204.98 in expenses. So your net income would be $26,495.02. But we're just gonna round it up, $26,495. Now let's move on to a lease on operator. So as a lease on operator, you would probably be making around 70 to 75% of the gross income. So I already calculated that. That's around $29,775 if you're making 75% of the gross. Now, in terms of expenses, even though you have to cover all your expenses, you don't have to cover all of these expenses right here. So let me explain. So as a lease on operator, what expenses out of these are you not responsible for? Well, number one, you're not responsible for paying for the accountant, right? For the carrier. That's pretty obvious. Number two, you're not responsible for paying for the DAT load board, because you know what? In that 25% that the carrier takes, The dispatching and the load board is included in that 25%. They should not be charging you for a load board. Now fuel. Yes, you would be responsible for the fuel you purchase on this truck. You would also be responsible for paying for the insurance, and this is usually deducted from your paycheck. ELD. No, the carrier is supposed to cover the ELD. Maintenance. Yes, absolutely. You're responsible for paying for the maintenance. Permits. Now, usually you would be responsible for paying for permits that are related to your truck, like a Kentucky permit or an Oregon trip permit, something like that. Now, in this case, the permit refers to the EPN program, which is only for an employer. So this permit in this case is not your responsibility, so we're crossing it out. Taxes. Now, remember how I said this would be important. $900 out of these taxes were actually an LLC tax for us to run the company, to be able to continue with our company. The rest of it was related to this truck's taxes. But $900 out of this amount was just a company expense. So are you responsible for those $900? Absolutely not. You would be responsible for the difference. So we're gonna write it right here, $203.30. Now, tools for the truck. These things, of course, you would be responsible for as a lease on operator. Washes, truck washes. You as a lease on operator are responsible for paying your truck washes. So after all is said and done, and you pay for the fuel, you pay for the insurance, you pay for the maintenance, these taxes right here, not the total amount, the tools and the washes, the total expense comes out to $9,555, just about. So your total net income would be $20,220. So still not bad. Now, the big question is this. Do I recommend that you become a lease on operator or an own authority operator? So here's my answer. If you are currently just starting out and trying to learn this business and you don't know much about it, about how to run your own trucking company, I'd say go ahead and start as a lease on operator. Just find a good company that pays you enough money. If, on the other hand, you are someone who knows this business pretty well, you have a good idea of what it takes to run a trucking company, even if you're a little bit scared of making that first step, go and become your own authority operator. I 100% recommend that you get your own numbers. Why? Because you get to, number one, keep 100% of your income, minus the expenses, of course, but you can control your expenses. I hear a lot of excuses like, oh, I don't wanna get my own authority because the fuel card that the carrier provides is amazing and I get such great discounts, or the insurance cost is really, really low. Guys, speaking from a carrier's perspective who owns a company with its own numbers, let me tell you, in the beginning, I was running out shopping for those fuel cards, calling around, trying to find the best one to be able to offer this fuel card later to these owner operators who lease on. So if I can do it, and I'm not sure if you remember, but I used to think that a truck and trailer do not detach, you can do it for sure. You can find that great fuel card. Now, insurance is a little bit trickier because if you're a new authority and new venture, that means that your insurance costs will be a little bit higher. Now, if you're a new venture with a new CDL, it's gonna be a lot higher. So yes, this is a big benefit of leasing onto a carrier that's established, that has already managed to lower their insurance cost and pass it on to you. In terms of everything else, like maintenance, tire savings, you know what? Again, shop around. All of these carriers, at one point, someone from these companies went and shopped around for a good fuel card, a good savings card, and got a good deal. So you know what? You can too. And if your only excuse is the fact that you're more comfortable being a lease on operator because you don't have to worry so much about all the paperwork, that's not an excuse. I really, really highly recommend going the own authority way. And that's why we have that startup program in our company, because we want more people getting their own authority and really learning to run this business. The more owner operators on the road, the better, in my opinion. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one.